I came to Las Vegas, Nevada to take on the B3, the Big Badass Burrito Challenge at the NASCAR Cafe in the historic Sahara Hotel and Casino. If I can finish this 6-pound, 2-foot-long behemoth burrito, I win unlimited rides on Speed the Ride. Reaching 70 miles per hour in 2 seconds flat, Speed the Ride sits right on the strip in front of the Sahara. And I can't think of a better way to prepare for this challenge than taking a ride on my prize. Just when you think the ride is over, you do it again, backwards. If I win, it'll be my personal ride for life.
Awesome.
Revved up and raring to go, I enter NASCAR Cafe to get an idea of just how to attack a 6-pound, 2-foot-long burrito.
Would you go from end to end, or would you start in the middle?
I think that's where all the best stuff is, right in the middle.
Right in the middle? Maybe if I cut them apart, it looks like I just have to eat 2 big burritos. So then it's like I just got to finish this big burrito and then finish that big burrito.
But then you think once you got done with the first one, then you know, oh, I got another one to go.
Wow, I'm really in a damned if you do, damned if you don't kind of situation.
Only 2 people have conquered this 6-pound burrito since it debuted in early 2009. In the kitchen, I find its creator, executive chef Tim Emmert. He greets me with some chef whites, and we get to work.
Tell me how you came up with the idea of a burrito that is the exact weight and measurements of an infant.
All the food in here is huge, man. I mean, big portion. So we wanted to come up with like a gimmick in the, you know, for the restaurant. So I said, okay, let's do a burrito. And I don't know why, but the number 6 just stuck in my brain.
Cause you're evil.
It's time to make Tim's big bad brainchild. To begin, he loads up 4 16-inch tortillas with lettuce, rice, beans, cheese, and jalapenos. After piling on the beef, full of flavor from 9 hours of simmering, he tops it off with nacho cheese sauce, and we're ready to roll.
Let's deliver a B3.
But the burrito's not done yet. Tim adds sauce from the beef, more cheese, tomatoes, black olives, scallions, and scoops on sour cream and guacamole.
It looks like you're making a traffic light.
Bon appetit.
This somehow has to go in here and fit down here.
I exit the kitchen.
Viva la burrito!
Hopeful to become the 3rd person ever to conquer the B3. But before I begin, this is Vegas after all. The odds must be set.
I like Adam, Iron Gut Richmond, as a slight favorite over the Big Bad Burrito.
I work here.
No, I don't think he can do it.
I got 50 bucks on Adam.
I got 100 bucks on the burrito.
Escorted by a good-looking pit crew, I'm ready to run the high-stakes race.
You have 90 minutes to eat it.
Okay.
Okay, everything off the plate.
Okay.
If you don't, you get a passionate pink T-shirt that says, I'm a weenie, I couldn't do it.
Defeat would be humiliating, but the prize is well worth it. My picture on the Wall of Fame and a lifetime of rides on NASCAR's roller coaster, Speed. Let the quest for glory begin.
Get ready. Go.
All right. Really delicious. Luckily, I'm extremely hungry. Everything's fresh. Good burrito. Just a whole lot of it.
Food. 10 minutes in, and I've already put a serious dent in the bad. I'm more than a third of the way through.
About 13 minutes into Adam's challenge here, from my perspective, he's doing pretty good. I think he's gonna hit the brick wall here in a couple of minutes, but you know, who knows?
I can hear you.
Despite Tim's forecast, I close in on the 3-pound mark.
I'm looking at Adam. He's got it halfway down. He's doing pretty good. He might have a chance of doing it all.
I came all the way to Las Vegas's NASCAR Cafe for the race of my life. I have 90 minutes to devour a 6-pound, 2-foot-long burrito called the B3.
Okay, burrito, you are bonito.
15 minutes in, and just over a third of the burrito remains. I'm trying to become the third person ever to claim a spot on the Wall of Fame and earn unlimited roller coaster rides.
I've been eating for 30 minutes now.
Yep.
How am I doing for 30 minutes?
I think you're doing great.
I'm cruising toward the finish, ready to claim a victory for man. But then, just after the 35-minute mark, I hit the dreaded wall.
Dear sweet baby Vegas, all the blood has now gone to digesting this. Oh, my word. I mean, it's very yummy. The taste is the only thing helping me hang on this long.
60 minutes down, only 30 minutes left. I need to get back on the fast track to victory lane. Go, Ed, go. The Vegas crowd rallies behind me.
Go, Ed, go!
You can do it, Adam.
Can I have a pound? Oh, nice one. To come back from that and then look down and realize what I have to do.
Adam, I'm a psychotherapist. I have a positive affirmation for you.
Go for it.
You are the king of gastric feats.
Okay.
You should repeat that in your mind. You can do it.
With an uplifting mantra in my mind, I'm taking one more shot at the B3.
Let's just see how far we can go. You know, you climb Mount Everest because it's there. Here's the B3. I may as well pretend it's K2.
Go, Ed, go!
Man, you can do it!
You can do it, Adam!
But the next bite stops me in my tracks.
I was rooting for him, but I've got to tell you, the last few minutes, man's in trouble.
I'm gonna be honest, I can't put another bite of this meat in my mouth. I can't.
It's time to face the truth. While I'm full of beef and beans, I have run out of gas. Even though weeniehood awaits, I offer my reluctant surrender.
Today, two champions met in the NASCAR Cafe, the Sahara Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas. Today in the battle of man versus food, today, food won.
All in all, a respectable showing. I took on a 6-pound burrito and left only 1 pound on the table.
So give me that t-shirt, let's do this thing. I look good in pink. I'm a certified weenie.